And here we are in the last quarterfinals of Master Arena 4 between Terror, JonSnow, and Melkor, or he's playing as Matthias, as you can see right here. We have Persians against God in the first game. We can see for Terror, for JonSnow, Persians. Main gold pretty safe, second gold safe in the back, extra gold safe in the back. This is nice for him. The second stone is outside, the main stone for British, and that means we're missing one gold, a third gold pretty far outside, no big problem, I think. Then there's 1, 2, 3 relics relatively close, but somewhat in between the two players. The monastery coming up and a siege workshop for JonSnow immediately. And there is number 4 and 5, closer to Melkor's base, I guess. We have JonSnow 25 HP and, yeah, 30 HP for Melkor, so he had the first hit and Terra had to run away. Third gold outside here for Melkor. What is he going for? Extra gold inside for him as well. I did not scout it. The main gold and the main stone safe in the back. The town center coming up on the main stone and wood line, really nice position here. And looks like he's going for a boom. The second and third town center coming up. The second gold inside, the second stone outside forward. And Terra looks to be going aggressive. Not sure what he can do with Persians against like mid to late castle age Huskals. Let's see if that's the plan here. TC on the main stone would suggest he could go for a castle later on. Monastery coming up from Melkor only now, and the scout of course still on the field for both players. Actually the mangonel hitting the gate immediately, and that means Melkor needs a siege workshop really soon, probably around here or maybe on the right hand side, I don't know. So let's see how he's going to defend here and what JonSnow can do. Actually nice, killing a monkey with the scout, probably worth it, and then deleting the scout before it gets converted. JonSnow in the meantime collecting the relics in, and siege workshop not coming up yet. Second mangonel on the way though for JonSnow, no, third actually, and there is a villager. JonSnow probably found out about the house and he's going to attack here. Monk trying to convert the scout, it's not going to happen. Terra going second TC. Yeah, only a second TC for now, but it's alright. He is the one who's going aggressive, so he can delay his boom a little bit. And also he's in a score with those military units, of course. Let's see how this game is continuing and what JonSnow can do here. What can he see? He can see two TCs. He does not know about the gold or stones for now, at least not from the inside. He didn't go there, getting another relic in and destroying that house and the blacksmith first. A little bit of a waste of time. The siege workshop is up in the back and there's a mangonel. Let's see, Melkor, can you get a good shot in? That's one for nothing. Splitting the mangonels and going back immediately here, JonSnow, to get number 3 in. And looks like Melkor got a good boom coming in. Mini boom, boom, whatever you call it. I guess it's called mini boom usually. And nice preparing for JonSnow, attacking the TC now. That's 1 for 2 for nothing. 3 for 1 mangonel. Really strong. Siege workshop coming up forward here. And loom coming up for Melkor to make sure the villagers, those villagers are not going to die easily. Let's see, JonSnow. 2, 3 TCs now. Melkor 400 stone almost in the bank, so he may be able to go for a castle really soon if he wants to. He could buy his way up to get more stone in, but what an amazing defense with the mangonels here. Now tries to get a castle up in between those 2 TCs. Nice splits with the villagers, and then again 1 for 1 is good for Melkor in this case because the castle will go up. And that's 1 dead villager and still a few of them building. Another mangonel approaching, it's 3 against 1, but 1 going onto the TC fire and 1 for 1 here. That means by the cost of a few villagers only, this castle should go up, and TC is actually hitting those mangonels. Look at this, another mangonel is up. And looks like Terror on the way to Imperialage soon. He sold a lot of resources. Yeah, he's gonna be able to click up soon. But what can he do against that castle, against the Huskals that probably are gonna come in soon or not? I don't know. What's the plan for Melkor here? He's low on resources, but he's gonna have stone for a second castle soon. And Imperialage for JonSnow might change this game. Is Persians actually favored here? I really don't know. And I don't have enough experience in Arena to really call that, to make that call, because you need to play to get experience. Just watching games, it's gonna give you a little bit of an idea, but it's not really helpful to play or to predict a lot of things. When you have played the games, you know what's happening. Barracks coming up now, and I guess Anarchy is on the way or was done already. Not too sure. Are we gonna see Pikemen now? That's Blacksmith. There's the Barracks coming up. Anarchy now on the way. Let's with scale mill armor, enough stone for that second castle. As we said before, there's 2 siege workshops inside Melkor space for JonSnow. And JonSnow handcart chemistry coming in, going probably for archer rangers. Yes, hand cleaners, probably a good choice. And there's more barracks on the way. But we are going to see Huskals now. I'm assuming at least that it's going to be Huskals in the barracks. Yeah, Anarchy was done, so more and more Huskals coming in. And this could be a very close fight, to be honest, with Melkor staying in castle age. Very late castle age actually with the Huskals. 6 plus 1 defense is done. And hand cleaning production started for JonSnow. Also bomber cannons to hit the castle. I guess Melkor can afford to lose a castle. He doesn't want to because then his front entrance is open. Let's go like this. Few Villagers going out to try and maybe get a little bit of gold in on the TC, but not happening. There is monks, there is hand cleaners already. And now there's also an archer range and the house coming up to block this. The Huskar's moving in to actually go away again because probably too many hand cleaners already. And I like this little wall off, it's perfect. Jon Snow utilizing the villagers here and making house walls to make sure that those Huskar's can approach an open field hand cleaners. Now, nice houses on the walls to make sure that petards won't be the biggest problem. And the Huskar's on the open field finding nothing. Jon Snow should have 5 relics instead, it's 4, I guess. One for Melkor then? Yeah, looks like it. And Imperial Age halfway done for Melkor as well. But those Huskars are pretty much doing nothing for now. Nice wall up on the right hand side. And JonSnow still attacking the castle, still getting more hand cannoneers. Yeah, a lot of production actually going on. And there is not enough Huskars yet to be able to face this, to fight this. Melkor now soon up to Imperial Age. Not enough resources to get the elite Huskar upgrade done. He had to produce too much. But he's repairing that castle and he's staying on repairing that for quite some time. Is there a second castle up somewhere? I don't see it. He had more stone before. TC coming up here. And now elite Huskar upgrade on the way actually. He had enough resources to get that. And Huskar's moving in just before the castle going up. But elite Huskar is not finishing because the castle is not there any longer. And not enough Huskars to be able to attack this. So Melkor has to go back here. Pretty difficult position at this point. Another castle coming up in the back. He should have had that way earlier, in my opinion. And the Huskars not able to take down all the hand cannoneers. That's just a lot of them. And the bombard cannons behind that. JonSnow with a really, really nice push here. Going to Imperial Age faster, getting the hand cannoneers out. Maybe the Persians are a bit of civilization here. I guess could have attacked with the Huskars in mid-castle age, like get aggressive. But JonSnow was the one who went aggressive. The castle coming up forward now. And the bombard cannons are taking down a lot of buildings here. Huskars on the open field are doing nothing. They're just being idled here. And Terra is pretty safe at home, while this castle probably going up soon and the Huskars won't be able to go there to take this castle down. This castle from Melkor is not gonna stand for too long if JonSnow, not unit spy. Focal 4, that's what I want to see. Can you see the castle? Not yet. Elite Huskar upgrade is done, of course, and 8+2 defense is there. But that's still not enough to take down all the hand cannoneers and mangonels. Now Melkor is moving in, trying to get rid of that big ass army, but these Huskars are dying too fast. There's just too many hand cannoneers around. And I think this is probably the GG because this castle is going up, conscription on the way, and the castle from Melkor could fall next. Doesn't have a lot of military units left, it's like 18, and there's the GG from Melkor. Nice push here by JonSnow, game 1 going to the win for him. And here goes game 2 between JonSnow and Melkor. JonSnow is in stone with Goth. This map not really too good. Main gold forward, main stone forward, second and third gold and second stone outside. Only the second gold safe in the back. JonSnow found that. He has a little bit of a back base if he wants to go there. And I guess he's gonna go at least 3 TCs. But the castle is gonna come up first. And he's with 4 villages on gold as well. Let's see how this game is going. Relics more or less in the middle. 3 here, close to extra gold, extra stone, another extra gold on the left hand side, and 2 more relics. We have Melkor at home with the stable up, going with the market and stables. No blacksmith, probably doesn't need it. Not a really nice main gold, but he's got 7 villagers on that. Looks like he wants to go aggressive. Double lumber camp here on the right hand side. And the scout's out. Did JonSnow lose a scout? No, it must be somewhere around. I don't see it yet. Is it at home? There is a castle coming up on the main gold, and a monastery is coming up too. But where's that scout for JonSnow? I don't see it yet. I want to find it. And no, he lost it. Oh, sorry. 0 military units. I looked at the wrong point, the wrong table, or the wrong, how to call that, column, something like that. I don't know. Double monastery coming up for Melkor with Persians. Looks like he wants to go really aggressive here, not going for any extra TCs for now. And we have one monk out to get that scout not converted, but a siege workshop is coming forward and a blacksmith is forward as well. Can JonSnow see this? Let me check. What does he know about the map for now? What does he know? He can see the siege workshop. Let's go a little bit faster, see what's happening here. JonSnow has that castle on the right hand side. He's still open, so I'm not sure what he can do here. The monk's going out, but the conversion is starting too late. That's one monk. 2 monks for 1 scout, for 2 scouts, and 1 conversion successful. The Huskars are gonna make sure that Mangonel is not doing anything. And there's the monks approaching, monks against Huskar. We know this is going to end. That's 1, 2, and 2 conversions, 1 Huskar going down as well. Melkor is looking good for now, collecting the relics. Also JonSnow getting a relic in, nice to see. Does Melkor know about the relics on the right-hand side? He can see them, yes, so he will be able to intercept that monk, probably. Where's JonSnow going? Going around, probably he expected that scout. And the Mangonel cannot see, the scout is patrolling the right-hand side, and it's going to find the monk. A little bit lucky, but expected to see that. Another siege workshop coming up forward, where's the villager for that? Guess it's coming only now. And we have 45 against 46 and 47, same villager number, pretty much. Melkor bought some stone, too. I don't know what to do. We have two TCs, three TCs up for JonSnow. Melkor with only one TC for now. One, two TCs. Second and third TC coming in now. And he's still going aggressive. Three Mangonels. He's going to be able to go in really soon now. And JonSnow won't have an easy time to stop this because the House Guards alone are not going to do it. There's only six of them. But there is like six monks as well. And that means the push from the Persians here will be dangerous. Not sure if you should go for your own Siege Workshop and Mangonel defense. Persians get the Redemption upgrade, I'm really not sure. I don't want to look it up now, because that monastery is about to go down. The Mangonels will move forward, of course. Melkor knows about the cast here, so he's gonna stick to the right-hand side. No stone walls coming up, because we have both Earth player here. JonSnow cannot build stone walls. And that means he needs to use military units to defend from this. That's not gonna be easy, because there's seven Mangonels already. JonSnow not doing anarchy and probably getting a few barracks in the back. But he's housed on 90, he's losing houses here. That's terrible. This should never happen. If you have your houses attacked, build more of them. And JonSnow resources looking okay-ish, but I still cannot reduce, and that's really terrific. It's terrible. TC, the main TC about to go down. There's the House Guards moving, but even Scorpions there. Camel, not sure why. And those House Guards doing down fast. A few Mangonels dying. It's not a big problem. There's enough House Guards, enough Monks and Mangonels left to attack this TC. And like this was expected, the numbers weren't high enough for JonSnow here. Now there's more coming in. We slow down just a little bit to see if the remaining House Guards can do some damage here. Nice shot to the Mangonels. One of them getting converted. The Monks will die now. And the Mangonels as well. Ooh, looking good for JonSnow at this point. 16 against 11 military units. He was able to push this back, actually, and to make sure that Melkor cannot attack him any longer. Good job here. He's getting an arm on the way. But Imperial Age click for Melkor. Was just about to look at his resources. And he's getting more farms up. He's got 3 TC up and running. A lot of farms. And more coming up as well. And with Imperial Age, he probably will go for the chemistry upgrade as well. Few more houses on the front to have some vision, I guess. Now the Huskals are moving in, and we do see a weak point, but there's also Monks and Huskals remaining. The Mangonel and Monk will die. Loom, Heavy Plow, Wheelbarrow, Vulture, Binding, all coming in. So JonSnow probably won't be able to go in and do a lot of damage here. There is just too many military units, too many monks. The siege workshops will go down though, and that's at least something that the Huskals can do. JonSnow close to clicking up to Imperial Age, but at the same time, Melkor is almost there. Now the question is, can Melkor get chemistry immediately? Does he have a university? No, apparently not. I think my hotkeys are still correct and working. Now the university is up. You're going to see chemistry coming in immediately. And then maybe a few archer rangers on the way. Don't see them yet. This village has built a few houses, but they will go down now. And this is a slow approach now, so let's go faster. Let me see what's happening now. Barracks coming up at home. More barracks, actually. Archer range. Did you forget about the first barracks? Maybe he did, actually. Because I didn't really need this one. I think that's the classic. I need a barracks before I need archer ranges. And now the archer ranges are gonna start and produce a lot of hand cannoneers. In the meantime, JonSnow waiting for Imperial Age to come in and probably Elite Huskal on the way. Yes, there we go. Let's see how this is going to end. Handcart crop rotation coming in for him as well. More villagers for Melkor here, but it's not a big difference. And the big difference is that Goth can produce really, really fast. Of course, JonSnow now is low on food. House on the right hand side remain for now. On the map, on the field, Tumors of Blast Furnace. Perfusion coming in. What an important upgrade for the Goth here. And Melkor is actually allowing JonSnow to get it. Now JonSnow is moving out the first time. Let's go to like 84 speed is okay. Terminal Ring Arch Armor. There's the Hand Cannoneers against the Huskals. And the first Huskals are about to die. Not a lot of monks left, and those Huskals, there could be enough numbers to take the Hand Cannoneers down, of course, to get an attack damage bonus. And yes, there is enough of them, actually. The Hand Cannoneers, there's a few of them remaining, but also more Huskals coming in. Attacking the monks was a mistake, in my opinion. Should have stuck to the Hand Cannoneers here. But we can see JonSnow is sending more and more and more and more. The Huskals on the way, this is just crazy. As long as there's Hand Cannoneers on the field, you don't need champions, because champions will die too fast. But the Huskals can do the job, and JonSnow has a good eco going, 120 plus villagers, they're all working, or almost all of them, and he's still got a good gold income. So for now, he's in the favorite, in my opinion, to win this game, because a fully boomed god is not easy to beat with Persians, unless you have a lot of gold and maybe like paladins on the way. Paladins plus hand cleaners would be awesome, but Siege Workshop's coming up forward for JonSnow, and he's probably gonna go and destroy the TC very fast. Extra gold on the left being taken by Melkor, but only one villager, it's really not a lot. Scale building on our husband, we're on the way now. And there's a castle coming up to protect the entrance of the base and the rest of the main gold, I guess. A few stone walls coming up to protect the second stone as well. Oh, sorry, that's stone, not gold. My fault. More siege workshops on the way, and capped ram on the way as battering rams coming up. Maybe JonSnow could go for chemistry too. But look at this, this TC is idle and is going to die now. More husks, barracks coming up on the right hand side. And light cav conscription chain barding armor. Looks like Melkor won't have the gold he needs. Wow, resources, that's crazy. What are you going to do with all the resources? Are still producing hand cleaners? A few of them. But Melkor is floating resources. Hassaros, blade barding armor. Looks like this is going to be a long game. I'm going to go a little bit faster now. Wait for that battering ram or cap ram attack to happen. And our Huskals will go in soon. But I think Melkor has enough military units to be able to stop this for now. Let's see. Huskals, the Hussars should not go out like this. And the hand cleaner should stay somewhere behind walls and buildings. This is looking to be a good fighting position for Melkor. And I guess JonSnow should not go in like that. I think he should get up rid of the castle first. Sorry, rid of the castle. Speaking fast, of course. And maybe get his own hand cleaners. Or Onager would be an option too. Now, like this, he's throwing away a lot of Huskals. This is not a good fight for JonSnow. He shouldn't have gone in. It was a very bad fight indeed. And the hand cleaners are almost untouched. What are you doing? Put your Huskars into the rams, maybe. That would be a better option. It's not happening. The monastery is going down, but JonSnow is losing too many units, in my opinion. Melkor, though, is low on food, and JonSnow is getting more and more of the Huskars. So let me check the resources quickly. Looking all right for JonSnow. And there's more. The Hussars are going to do the trick here. And the hand cleaners need to be protected. They are for now, but this is just beautiful. There's Huskals coming in from everywhere. And now buying food. Melkor is buying food. This is not looking good for him. He needs more farmers. Doesn't have the space for it. I thought the base was big enough, but apparently not. And the Huskals, the poor flood of Huskals, pure numbers, are winning this, as well as the cap rams. Look at this. JonSnow is sure is a fan of siege rams. He cannot get siege rams got, but looks like the battering rams, the cap rams, sorry, will do just as fine. And there's more and more Huskars coming in. I don't know, the Hussars going around somewhere, not sure why. More better, no, more cap rams, more Hussars, more Huskars, more everything. Looks like JonSnow is about to take the second game as well, which is amazing to see. I thought Melkor would be able to take this, but JonSnow was able to defend back then in his base, and Melkor calling the GG. He knows this is over. He's got a lot of resources. This is just crazy, but he wasn't able to get enough units out. And against the fully boomed post-Imperial Age Goth player, it's really hard to fight on Arena. Let's go into the Mayans War Game 3. Here it is. So let's see what's going to happen in this game. JonSnow got a pretty beautiful map here. 40 are inside. Main gold safe in the back. Main stone safe in the back. Second gold safe in the back. Extra gold, which he's probably about to find because he's sending the scout in. Scout is 1 HP. That's because Melkor lost the scout, actually. Second stone and third gold outside only. Two relics close to space. One inside. So the map for JonSnow looking really good. Melkor main gold safe in the back and second stone. The main stone is forward. He's not on stone at all. Going to the monastery. Had to mill the deer outside. He had 4 of them. Third gold is outside, the second gold, I'm not sure, probably this is the second gold and this is the third one outside. Two relics close to his base, extra gold here, the other extra gold we've seen inside, and there's the extra stone. What else we have? We get a TC up for Melkor, a second TC on the wood line, and a third TC on the wood line, and the stone here. Nice TC positions, wheelbarrow coming in immediately, not sure, maybe it was housed, something like that. But it's not going for any plumed arch or something, so, but instead three TCs. Could be interesting to see how Taro is going to make use of his map control and plumed arches and whatever. Is he going for plumes here? Apparently not. Looks like he wants to go for a fast Imperial Age, or is he going for extra TCs? He doesn't have enough villages on gold to go fast imp. Not sure what this build order is about. Doesn't really look too good, to be honest. He's got 650 food in the bank and no gold, not enough gold here. Should have had more gold, but I think he wants to go fast imp. Maybe it's not too far away. Getting the relics from Melkor's base, Melkor got a monastery up. So I was trying to go for the relics, he's got one in already. The Eagle Warrior is still there. I guess it's not easy to approach those monks with that Eagle, because there's two of them. Now JonSnow is able to get all the relics in, and he's gonna be able to click up before 21 minutes. He should be able to. Yep, there we go. No, not yet. Finally. 21.08. Heavy plow coming in from Melkor, of course, he's got the villager advantage. JonSnow is on stone, so he's gonna have enough stone for another castle once he reaches Imperial Age. And he needs to go forward then, probably. The problem for him is the distance between both is pretty big, actually, so he needs to walk pretty far. But with the fast imp, he should have a big advantage for now. As for Melkor, he's not really close to Imperial Age. He is with 63 villagers, 62. Did he lose a villager now? Maybe there was one converted, or maybe he had to delete one. And there is a barracks now coming up, probably to get a few elite eagle warriors out. Mine came with the main stone, but it didn't take too much because there's a monk also. Now there is two monks trying to convert, one plumed archer at least. There is two conversions? Was it one or two? I think it was one, and that monk is getting away, but the Eagle Warrior should be... No, what are you doing, JonSnow? Did you not see the monk? You should be able to see it. What the hell? Cannot see the monk? Amazing. That monk will remain there for now. Forward castle is up, and the first trebuchet coming out. Ballistics also on the way for JonSnow. Is he going for Bracer? Yeah, Bracer is done. Doesn't have a lot of economy. This is an all-in play here. Fast Imp usually is an all-in. And the first trap is going to attack, I hope, the barracks here, I guess. But the monastery is going down first. This monk should be able to get another conversion in. The plumed archer is now moving forward. Imperial Age halfway done for Melkor. What is he going to do? I guess Elite Eagle Warrior is what he wants to do here. He's prepared that in this economy. Mangonel trying to hit the plumed archers, but they are pretty fast here. Can they get a few plumed archers? Can the Mangonel... Beast, and yes, for now it's looking good. Three mangonels against six plumed archers. We know this is going to end. But one villager at least going down. And now there's a castle coming up in the back. The market, I guess, but no, it wasn't a siege workshop, but a market. I guess it was a market. TC is down as well. Melkor is up to Imperial Age. We should see the Elite Eagle Warrior upgrade coming very soon. He doesn't have a lot of resources for that. Now he has enough. But no barracks remaining. No, that's terrible. You should have gotten more barracks earlier on. Market coming up in the back here, and a few more houses. JonSnow looking good. I think we haven't seen a 3-0 in best of 7 yet. But this might be the one. Onager coming in though. And that's a very important and very good upgrade against plumed archers and trebuchets. 5 mangonels. And JonSnow needs siege rams, I think, or his own onagers to be able to face this. I don't think he's going for the Eagle Warriors. Cannot really afford this. He cannot really afford anything. That being said, Elite Eagle Warrior on the way. Interesting. Then Onages won't really be too good. Can JonSnow take the 3-0 home, actually? Maybe even a 4-0, but that wouldn't really be showing how good Melkor is. Melkor now with two trebuchets attacking this castle. Where's the counter traps? They're standing behind. And Eagle Warrior is moving in, but the Onager is doing a good job of taking those down. I guess this Onager should die now. And that's 1-2 going down. Doom Arch is approaching to take down the trebuchets. And more Elite Eagle Warrior is moving in. Nice shot with the Onagers, actually. And this trebuchet is still standing. The castle being repaired for now. TC not being attacked yet. And Melkor in a score lead with more population, of course, but it's a lot more villagers. Now the Plumed Archers going in to try and take down Onagers. The Elite Eagle Warriors will have to do the job. And the trebuchets need to go back. The castle is still standing. JonSnow for now doing a good job. And he's still the one who's going aggressive. But another castle coming up, and that means maybe Melkor will be able to switch into Elite Plumed Archers, or at least Plumed Archers. He could go for the Elite upgrade immediately, he's got the resources for that. The Plumed Archer production starting for now. Elite Eagle Warriors approaching the trebuchets, and the Onager is actually taking care of the trebuchets, taking them down. What kind of ballistics? We are going to see a lot of Plumed Archers against. Yeah, they don't have too many upgrades actually. The Elite Plumed Archer missing for JonSnow. And wasn't there a castle? Ooh, JonSnow was able to take down one of the castles. Melkor will make sure to keep this castle alive, but he's not going for Elite Plume for now. He's got a few Plumed Archers here, but not Elite yet. Elite Eagle Warriors though, no upgrades whatsoever, and that means they're dying pretty fast. The Onagers will make sure the trebuchet is going down. One trap for one Onager, but two actually. So JonSnow is going to be able to take down the last castle as well. Nice Onager shot here. Nice micro, look at this. The villagers need to repair, but one trebuchet going down, and the Onager dodging every shot. Now that Eagle Warrior almost there, but going down. Look at this, this is just crazy. JonSnow doesn't have any other units here but those trebuchets, and he wasn't able to produce enough, so he's calling GG here. I don't think he should have called GG yet. He could have come back maybe, but 46 villagers on the other end is really not a lot, and Melkor able to defend for as long as he needed to make Jero call a GG. Let's go to game 4, but in the next set, or next part of the set. GG.